I hate Twitter. You love it, don't you? Young, you go, Twitter, oh, brilliant, Stu. Virtual online utopian futuristic society. Direct communication between the individuals. Unfettered by government interference. Freedom of information. Arab Spring. We love Twitter. I hate Twitter. The only good thing about Twitter is if I'd have a mental breakdown and forget everything that had ever happened to me, I could gradually piece my life back together by putting my name into the search engine in Twitter. Because about every 90 minutes, one of you feels obliged to do an update of where I am and what I'm doing. 8:30 a.m. Can't believe it. Just seen Stuart Lee taking his son to school on the 393 bus. They're talking about Scooby-Doo. He looks depressed. 10 a.m. Can't believe it. I am sitting next to Stuart Lee in the Clock Cafe, Highbury. He is eating a muffin. He looks fat. 11:30 a.m. Hackney celebrity alert. Just seen Stuart Lee walking around Abney Park Cemetery on his own. He looks fat and depressed. 1:30 p.m. Wowaroonie. Just seen Stuart Lee walking around Dalston Junction on his own, eating a burger in the street. He looks fat and depressed and fat. I hate Twitter. It's like a state surveillance agency run by gullible volunteers. It's a Stasi for the Angry Birds generation. If you're an F-list celebrity, like, makes your life impossible, you're paranoid all the time, being spied on. I'll give you an example of what I mean. Last October, I was driving along the M40. I wasn't going to do a gig this time. I was going to Birmingham to put flowers on the grave of a relative. And I stopped at the Charwell services. I went in the Waitrose florist there. I got a big bunch of flowers. And on the way out, the woman on the perfume concession stand caught my eye and she said to me, "Perfume, sir, to go with the flowers for the lady." And I went, "They're for someone's grave." And she went, "Oh." And the other woman went, "Oh, no." And then there was all people standing around going, "Oh, look, look at what's happened, oh." I thought, this will be on Twitter, exactly the kind of thing that goes on Twitter. So I thought I'd say something lighthearted to bring the event to a close, you know. So I said to her, "Oh, never mind, give us some perfume. I'll spray it around all the graves." Got home, looked it up on Twitter. You have to look everything up on Twitter now, don't you? Stay in touch with what's around you. Woman's feed comes up. The comedian, in inverted commas, Stuart Lee, came in our perfume stand today. He is even less funny in real life. You know what? That didn't happen. It sort of happened a bit. But I changed it for comic effect. Because what really happened is just bleak. I was going to Birmingham to put flowers on a grave. And the woman did say to me, "Perfume, sir, to go with the flowers for the lady." But I didn't say any of that stuff. Just said, "Oh, for fuck's sake." Excuse me. Yeah, in your job, I'm not threatening you, I'm just saying. there's a lot of reasons, aren't there, why someone could be buying flowers. And I know that you... I know you have to hit targets and, but, you know, maybe you should think about what those, all those reasons, what they could be before you just, you know. So, Got home, looked it up on Twitter. Woman's feed comes up. General Ratcombe Ladditch came in there. He's even more grumpy in real life. Internet, Twitter, and I hate it. It drives you mad. Facebook and all these message boards. 5 minutes on Google, right? I can put my name in. I'll find hundreds of people all slagging me off. I'm going to read out some quotes now. 5 minutes on Google. These are real, right? In the context of the show, you have to appreciate this. The first four quotes from Americans that I read out, three of them were real. I only made one up. The letters, people complaining about Islam, they were exaggerated versions of real ones I've had. The quote from the guy in Dubai, that was real, verbatim. And then all the things about the Jungle Canyon rope bridges, they were real political speeches from the past. But I replaced the policy things in them. Yeah. From the Scooby-Doo, yeah. Now... Okay, these are all real. 5 minutes on Google. Can I have the jazz music and the lighting change, please? Rowing Rob on The Guardian's comment is free site calls me a sneering tosser. Tokyo Fist on YouTube writes, smug elitist liberalism, who is this cunt? Warto15 on Twitter writes, I hate Stuart Lee with a passion. He's like Ian Huntley to me. Huey on YouTube says, Stuart Lee, I will shove my thick cock in your throat, you gay lord. Z Factor on Twitter writes, Stuart Lee addresses an insular cadre of socially challenged, prematurely middle-aged, pseudo-intellectual men. I know, yeah, not as exclusively as I'd like, to be honest. But it won't, it'll just be us again soon. It won't last. It can't last. We're back to one night and then be all right. A Pudabaya writes, I spent the entire show thinking of how much I want to punch Stuart Lee in his face. The fucking smug face cunt. And that's on a website that is actually called beexcellenttoeachother.com. A Jimmy Vespa on don'tstartmeoff.com writes, a shit-haired cunt who resides at the very apex of all that is absolute patience-testing wank. Seriously, when there is the comedy equivalent of the Nuremberg trials, this bastard is going to be hung from the highest fucking lamppost, pelted with wasps' nests and dog turds, and eventually blasted with a flamethrower. Fucking hell, he concludes. I can't put into words... ...how much I detest this utter fucking cunt. Man in a banana suit on The Guardian site writes, Stuart Lee has made a career out of smugness. I hope fucking Crohn's disease kills him. A Ricardo writes, whenever I see his photo, I dream he's just seen my boot a split second before it rips his face inside out. Shindig on the dugout.net calls me an aging cunt with an Eskimo face from the 90s. One from Mumsnet here. Queen of the Harpies says, my mate had a huge crush on Stuart Lee, but even she's starting to admit time hasn't been kind to him. And this one's from a Sheffield football website, and it says, I know this guy, not well, but I can confirm that he is a cock. I've spoken to him several times in the past at various get-togethers, although not recently, and he is a pillock. He used to go out with my wife's cousin. He came up a few times for Christmas and one or two other things. I found him condescending and arrogant. Anyway, they've split up now, and my wife's cousin seems a lot happier. I mean, I know who that is, obviously. Unbelievable, isn't it? The funny thing is, I used to really like that guy, you know. Is your cousin's husband going to be there at Christmas? Oh, great, you know, get him a wedding present he used to like. He used to get him some records. Then you find that ten years later, you find that, you know. He used to go out with him. We went to the Hyena Club in Newcastle one 1999, November, to see Lewis Schaefer, American comic, and then we went in the comics bar, you know, till about 3, with him. You know, you want a drink, mate? Yeah, brilliant, you know, great. Then you think, what was he actually thinking, you know? Again, I fucking hate this bloke, you know. Don't get that, do you, in your lives? You don't get it. What's done is done. It doesn't come back. His mum, right? The guy who wrote that's mum. I had her to stay with me for about a week in London. When I lived in the flat above the estate agents by the fire station, if you remember that. Not a big flat. You know, she was on some course. She was like an old hippie. I really liked her, actually. I remember it was a Saturday afternoon, and I was putting some old bed together, and I had a record on. She was there. I had an old vinyl, the second album by Dr. Strangely Strange, an Irish folk rock band, the 70s. And his mum that wrote that, his mum, she goes, oh, I used to love this record when I was a kid. I haven't heard it for 30 years, and she knew all the words, and, you know. And this was before downloads and CD reissues and stuff, and I said to her, you can have it. And I gave the mum of the guy that wrote that my original Island Pressing pink label gatefold sleeve second Doctor Strangely Strange album, like a cock would. That's a condescending thing to do, isn't it? To give an old woman something of irreplaceable value that she would love. This is just some. I've got a 40,000 word document of all this. Because I thought it'd be funny, look on the internet, see for a bit in the show. But I didn't realise it would be so much. It's like pulling a thread. You start, you can't, and everything unravels. Knowing this is all there, it makes it quite hard to do this if you think about it, right? You think, oh, just go out in the world, interact with some people, have a laugh. Don't walk out during this. This is bad, right? It's bad for someone to say they hope you die on the internet, but that is worse. What is it about this bit that you don't buy into? You think, oh, I don't feel he's working hard enough, really. The fuck are you? You go out now, do you think, oh, I mean, this is obviously nearly the end of the show, isn't it? I can't recover it from this. Oh, I'll go out for a bit. I'll come back in when it's funny again. It won't be. It's not going to be funny again, is it? You're being a comic when you know you're under surveillance by people that despise you. It's quite hard. You think, oh, go out in the world, interact with some people, get some ideas, have a laugh with them. Go in the shop, have a laugh with the bloke, bit of banter, get home, you know, get some money, get home, you look on the internet, a fucking cunt came in my shop today. He reminded me of a paedophile who would kill a child. I hope he dies from a wasting disease. And all cocks go in his mouth. The fucking Eskimo-faced cunt. And it's all there, all out there. And you say, don't you? I've seen you. You go, look at us, virtual online, Facebook friends, Twitter community, virtual online utopian vision of tomorrow's better. What are you? You're like rats fighting in a ditch. Over some piss. So, you'll forgive me if there isn't really much of a show this year. Just...